The Vedic Voice channel heartily welcomes you for a presentation on, What are the Seven Horses of the Sunday? The ancients were heart-oriented people and all their scientific sayings too were expressed in the language of the heart, in the poetic form, whereas the modern society is mainly mind-oriented. All the ancient stories, symbols etc., in fact have deeper meanings. Another advantage of this poetic language is that, a single expression has many meanings at the same and it is not possible in the language of the mind, the language of the modern scientists. For example, the famous equation of Albert Einstein E equals to mc square has only one precise meaning that appeals equally to all the people. But, a single ancient saying or parable has many meanings and this meaning depends on the maturity of the person hearing it. Each person understands the ancient sayings in his or her own way, depending on their maturity level. In other words, the ancient scriptures are more like mirrors that reflect the onlooker. That is, depending on the maturity of the reader or listener, it is understood differently. If different persons look at a piece of a cloud, each one sees it differently. For example, one in love sees his beloved in the cloud, a child sees its mother and another child sees a toy in it, a religious person might see an angle there, a witch might see a ghost, a police could a thief could see a police or a treasure, and so on and so forth. Depending on the maturity, taste, mentality, or situation, it is understood differently. Same is the case with the sastras, the ancient scriptures. They reveal different things to different people, and of course all the meanings will be helpful to the individuals concerned. But the modern scientific equations have only one well-defined meaning. Whether they are understood in full or not understood at all, as they have only one precise meaning. In contrary to this, the ancient sayings have a spectrum of meanings and are applicable to everyone exposed to them as they have a broader perspective. On the same track, the sun riding on seven horses is nothing but the symbolic representation of the seven colors of the sun. The modern concept of the frequencies of the light rays is not understandable to the ancients, but the horse's analogy is easily understandable to them. But, the ancients had the idea that the visible light indeed has seven colors in it. The sun is moving, and before the sun is moving, the rays of the sun are moving in advance. For example, if sun is coming toward me, before him his rays are moving. Symbolically, before a person moves on chariot, his riding horses are moving in advance. So, the ancients said that the sun is moving on his seven horses. These seven horses correspond to the seven rays in the visible region of the light, the Vibhjir. The ancient Hindu books also mention that the sun has many other horses that are not visible to the naked eye, and this is nothing but, they are referring to the infrared and ultraviolet rays of the Sunday. The different frequencies in the electromagnetic spectrum were simply referred to as different horses by the ancients. Thus, the sun riding on seven horses in fact has deeper meanings, and these are not the physical horses, and these symbolic representations are not mindless. In fact, they have deeper meanings, as are the other symbols, parables, and stories in the ancient jargon. If I say that my love is a rose, does it mean that my lover is a rose? Such are the ancient sayings having deeper meanings, and they must not be interpreted from the periphery.